Welcome back as we get ready for the start of the third period here. First off, a bit of an apology there as we lost the stream for a moment right before right at the end of the second period. Good news is we didn't miss any of the actual action. And we were able to get the problem fixed with plenty of time to spare to get us ready for the third period here. I was trying to go through the stats of the second period. Shots on goal were 13 to 12 for the Cougars. Overall, they are 18 to 16 for the Bombers. Power plays in that period. The Cougars went 0 for 2. Their third power play has 11 seconds remaining in it. They are 0 for 3 now on the game. Bombers did not get a power play in that second period. They are 0 for 2 on the afternoon. Third period is now underway, and the penalty is now expired. As I mentioned, there were only 11 seconds left in it when the period started. Bombers carrying the 3-goal lead. Here's Sim coming in, getting the shot away, and the save made by Bresson, and he'll hang on for a face-off here very early in this third period. Jordan Larade saying, great job with the stream so far, appreciate it. Well, I appreciate that, Jordan. Thank you so much for the kind words. And also hearing from Michelle Crane Murphy, watching from the parking lot. Thanks, Michelle. Believe me, we all wish you and everybody else who has to sit out in the parking lot could be here, but sitting inside a slightly warmer building than your cars are, I'm sure. And we do appreciate you following the regulations as they are currently set out. There's the puck stops in a bit of wet spot there, and it works to the Bombers' favor. There's a chance, and the shot ends up being blocked by Pilling. Here's O'Neill coming the other way now. There's a shot. Blocker save made by Burrows. And the puck cleared all the way down, picked up by McDougal. McDougal behind the net. Having trouble again as the puck stops in that wet ice there. Now a shot from Conrad. And perhaps, hindsight being 20-20, it might have been wise to wait another minute or two before starting this third period, as we've had a couple times now where the ice is not quite dried enough. It has worked to the Bombers' favor to create good opportunities for them. Now here comes Wallace coming in with a nice move, and the save made by Bresson. Another bit of trouble with the puck off to that left side of the net. That's three times now this period in the first minute and 50 seconds that the Cougars have had trouble on the left side of the net with that puck just stopping up and not being able to be carried properly. Now with it, Smith trying to wrap around. Puck rolls off the toe of his stick, and so the Cougars are able to get possession and come out to center. Here comes McDonald. McDonald with a shot. Burrows the save, and she'll hang on for a faceoff with 17:46 left to go here in period number three. And as I look down, I see Bresson going and taking a little skate over onto that left side of his net. Owen Bresson having to stand tall thanks to some less than ideal conditions in the early goings of this third period. Seymour with the puck, backing up with it. Has to continue to back up as McDonald is right on him. Now Seymour all the way behind the net. He'll come back out the right side and makes the pass across to the left over to Marshall. Marshall chasing it down in behind the net. Takes a bump but able to skate through it. Tries to make a centering pass. That's knocked down. Puck cleared as far as the line, held in. Shot taken there by McIsaac, and Burrows able to steer that one aside. Played back over to the wall. Cleared out of the zone by Austin. And now here's Dalton. Keegan Dalton takes the shot. Save made by Bresson, and the puck comes all the way to the near wall. McIsaac Works it across the ice, but nobody was over there. Now Clark with it, taking it, carrying it all the way back into his own zone. Now able to get it ahead to Reynolds. Here's Reynolds trying to work his way through. McKenzie able to hold him up. And then the quick little pass from Austin to McKenzie. McKenzie now works it forward. Tucker not able to get control of that one, and Pilling able to play it back. O'Neill on the pass ahead, gets it across. Reynolds working in down the left side. Reynolds takes it behind the net, throws it out in front. Puck bounces off of Tucker to the line, and Brown not able to hold it in. Sim avoids a hit from Brown. This time Sim can't avoid the hit, but is able to get the puck into the zone. McKenzie to Austin near side. Austin will dump it in right onto Bresson. Bresson settles it, and McNeil is back to pick up there. McNeil plays it around to the far side. Back in behind the net. Nearly 4.5 minutes gone here, third period. Still the 3-0 score line, as it has been since just over 5 minutes left to go in the second period. Here comes Sim. Sim trying to get a shot away, fanned on it slightly, and McNeil, able to make the block. Now coming in, McKenzie with a shot. That goes just over the crossbar, off the end boards, and John K. Martin, Johnny on the spot. The puck takes a fortunate bomber bounce off the end boards. Right to John K. Martin. And for Martin, that'll be his fifth goal of the season. Martin from McKenzie. John K. Martin's fifth goal, eighth point of the season, assisted by Dominic McKenzie. For McKenzie now, that is a six-point weekend after a five-point game yesterday. Delayed penalty coming up against the Bombers here, and as they touch up, interference is the indication. So the now the fifth power play of the game for the Cougars, as Mac Wallace goes off for interference at 5:21. Cougars 0 for 4 so far with the man advantage this afternoon. There's a shot by McIsaac, and the rebound cleared away from danger. Trying to get it settled down there was Marshall, but Smith able to get possession and send it down the length of the ice. Pilling has to go back and pick up. Pilling with Smith right on. Pilling ends up playing the puck over to O'Neill. O'Neill gets it across to the far side. There's a shot taken by, I think that might have been McDonald. Again, some of these guys with the jerseys tucked in, it's hard to tell what number is what. Oh, that was 10, not 18. So here's Seymour. Seymour coming in. Seymour with a shot. Toe save made there by Burrows. And Bombers able to clear the rebound out. 1:04 left to go in the penalty. McIsaac plays it across for O'Neill. O'Neill gets it to Marshall, who gets the shot away, and the save made by Burrows, and she'll hang on for yet another faceoff. 54 seconds left in the penalty, 13:33 left to go here in the third period, with the Bombers now leading it 4-0. What is that? Here's Reynolds with the puck, going across to the far side. Clark couldn't get it under control, and then McDonald couldn't quite grasp it either. Now McDonald will play it back to the point. Brown gives back to McDonald. There's a shot and another save by Burrows, and she'll hang on for another faceoff. 13-13 to go in the third. 34 seconds left to go in that Mac Wallace penalty for interference. Clark in for the faceoff against McDonald. Clark won the draw. Now Reynolds with the puck. Little give and go back to Reynolds. There's a shot, kick save, although that may have been going wide anyway. And now clear down the length of the ice. Just 18 seconds left in the penalty. Back to pick up is Brown. Brown allows Clark to carry it up. Here comes Clark working his way in. Gets the shot away. Burrows gets a piece of that. Puck comes all the way back to Reynolds at the point. He'll send it back down low. We're back to 5-on-5. Hanrahan in there, getting tied up by Austin. Hanrahan gets a little bit of help there from Clark. Clark now on the puck. He'll play it back to the line to Reynolds. Reynolds goes across far side. There's a shot by Brown. That gets blocked by McKenzie. And out come the Bombers. Puck turned over at the Cougar blue line. Back down into the Bomber zone. Austin on it. He'll play it around the boards to Martin. Martin ahead. That's a little too far in front of Spence. And now McIsaac coming up the other way. Here comes McIsaac working his way down the left wing. McIsaac tried to make it pass back. That's broken up by Spence as O'Neill was there waiting for it. But Spence able to make the break. And now backing with it is Cameron. He'll play it ahead. Puck turned over at the blue line. Bombers, Spence. He loses it, but there to pick up is Sim. Lane Sim gets it across. Martin can't get a backhand shot through as McIsaac was there to tie him up. Now picking up in the corner is Pilling. Pilling working his way ahead. Gives it to O'Neill. O'Neill in across the blue line. Knocked off the puck. Sim loses it to McIsaac. McIsaac will dump it in. And picking up off the inboards, Moore. Ahead intended for Spence, but that's broken up. It's back with Moore. Moore has a man all over him. O'Neill intercepts a pass. Now a backhand shot by Pilling, and that's steered aside by Burrows. Here comes Sim. Sim, his pass for Martin a little bit in front of him. Delayed offside indicated, so that'll give the Cougars some time. 10:43 to go, third period. Puck dumped in. With it now is Conrad. Conrad working his way ahead. Conrad intended for Mosier. That pass a little bit in front of him. Mosier loses it. And McIntosh pass over to Hanrahan to try and start the rush up the other way. But that pass a little bit in front of Hanrahan. And now the Bombers coming the other way. Here's Mosier. He's got Wallace with him. Mosier to Wallace. Wallace can't take the pass cleanly. Wallace chases it down in the corner. Tries to center it. That doesn't work, and now out come the Cougars again as we reach the midway point of this third period. There's a shot that goes off a leg and into the end boards. And now out come the Bombers yet again. Here's Smith. Smith waits, shoots, and the save made there by Bresson. Up to the point for Campbell. Campbell gives to Wallace. Wallace with the shot. That gets through. And Bresson able to make the save and hang on with 9:37 left to go here in the third period. One other in progress score, a bit of a surprise here. The Kings Valley Mutual Wildcats lead the Gulls 2-1. There's a shot and a save made by Burrows. We mentioned in the opening the Gulls just lost for the first time this season back yesterday to the Truro Bearcats. So to go from being 12-0 to being 12-1, well, that's one thing. There's a shot and a save by Burrows. But to possibly go from 12-0 to 12-2, that would be a bit of a surprise. And we're into the later stages of that game as well. They're nearly, at least according to the website, the last time marker that was indicated is 36 seconds short of the midway point of the third period. So their game started right around the same time ours did. So to see the Gulls trailing only by one, but still trailing at this point in that game, I'd call that a, and no disrespect to the Wildcats, just how dominant the Gulls have been this season, call that a bit of a surprise. Here we've got 9:05 left to go in the third period, and the hometown Wherewell Bombers leading it by a score of 4-0. Conrad with the puck behind the net, plays it ahead to Sim. Lane Sim trying to pick up speed as he comes through center. Here comes Sim. Sim trying to split through three guys, though that's not going to work, and the Cougars get it back out to center. Conrad now plays it across to Wallace. Or Spence, excuse me. Spence with a shot. Sim chases down the rebound. His shot goes wide. Spence able to get on the puck again. He fires a shot. That misses. Comes all the way back to the point to Conrad. Conrad with a shot. That goes off of McIsaac. And then McIsaac able to pick up the loose puck, get it up to Seymour, and the Cougars come out. Down into the corner, McIsaac out front for Seymour. And Burrow's able to stand tall with a close range shot there. 8:16 to go. Bombers coming in yet again. Here's Sim with another shot, saved by Bresson. And Bresson will hold on as John K. Martin was hanging around. Other games today, as we mentioned, the South Shore Lumberjacks host the Pro Hockey Life Harbor Storm, the Bedford Blue Battalion Barons host the Halifax Wolverines, Novas host the Rangers, and the Truro Bearcats hosting the Dartmouth Whalers. That comes to the line, there's a shot, it gets blocked. Picking up on the rebound was Martin, he fires wide, and the that'll go all the way down the ice. Hustling back to get onto it is Cole Thompson. Thompson plays it around. Now it's ahead for John K. Martin. Martin gives to Spence. Spence drops to Sim. Sim with the shot. That goes off a stick and up over the glass and out of play. We should mention our next broadcast of the Wherewell Bombers will not be their, or will be their next home game. Taking a quick look here. Saturday, next weekend, the Bombers host the Bedford Blue Battalion Barons. We will have that game here on Petter Pictou Sports through 360 Live. However, their game on Sunday, the 7th, will not be available due to a scheduling conflict. They'll be playing over on the other sheet of ice here in this building. And Petter Pictou Sports is going to be doing the week's midget game. There's a chance in front. Scramble! And the puck cleared away from danger by McKenzie, which garners much appreciation from the Bombers on the bench. Wallace with it now. Pass ahead for Smith. Here comes Caden Smith. Smith trying to get around Murphy. Smith gets the puck and gets it in somehow. Not quite sure how that got in. Sometimes you got to be lucky to be good. And for Caden Smith, that was the case there. Smith's team-leading 16th goal, team-leading 24th point, coming at 13:08 of the third period, making it a 5-0 lead. And the goal is unassisted at 13:08. So Caden Smith again, 16th goal, 24th point, leads the team in both of those categories. Unassisted at 13:08, excuse me, making it 5-0. And now here's Conrad. Conrad down towards the corner, working around McNeil. Throws it to the front. McNeil clears that pass away, but it goes right to Dalton. Dalton's shot. Now McNeil trying to clear away the rebound again. Getting a little bit of help there from, I believe that was Hanrahan. And now it comes ahead to McDonald. McDonald can't maintain control. Back to get it in his own zone. Conrad. Conrad cutting towards the middle of the ice. Conrad still with it, now able to play it up for McDonald. McDonald takes a bump there, and the puck comes around to the near side corner. 5:39 to go, third period. McIntosh with the long lead pass. Shot taken by Marshall. That goes off a skate or a stick and into the corner. Dalton with it now. Ahead for Steele. That hops over his stick and it'll go all the way to Cameron. Cameron plays it to Pilling. Pilling can't get away from John K. Martin. Martin looking around, and he will get a penalty here as soon as the Bombers touch the puck, and with Spence touching up, we do get the penalty, and then Spence and McIsaac end up colliding. And John K. Martin, when your glove and your stick end up leaving your grasp because you got them into the gear of another person, it's pretty easy to make a hooking call against John K. Martin at 14:51. So the sixth power play of the game now for the Cougars. They are 0-for-5 to this point. Here's Reynolds with the puck. Reynolds working in. Reynolds with the shot. And Thompson gets a piece of that, deflecting it down into the corner. There's another shot. That goes off a body in front and bounces wide. That comes back to Reynolds. He plays it down the boards. Cross ice pass for Clark. Clark with the shot. Thompson gets a piece of that, nearly deflects it at Burroughs, and she had to react quickly. Reynolds gives to Seymour. Seymour with the shot. That goes wide. Now pinching in Brown. Clark tries to center it for Seymour. His shot ends up hitting McDonald. And they scramble for it. Burroughs able to make an incredible save. What a save by Georgia Burroughs. Looked like a sure thing. But Burroughs able to get the leg out with 4:16 to go in the third period. 1:07 left to go in the Cougar power play. And for Burroughs, that is her 33rd save of the afternoon so far. Her 17th save in this period. Georgia Burroughs on fire this afternoon here at the Pictou County Wellness Center. O'Neill brings the puck in but got slowed up just enough at the blue line that it's an offside against the Cougars with 48 seconds left in the power play. So Bombers look like they will at worst keep pace with the teams at the top of the league. They'll finish the weekend closer to the Gulls than they started the weekend because the Gulls lost yesterday. There's a shot save made by Burroughs. Barring a miraculous comeback, a 5-goal deficit with 3.5 minutes left, you would need a pretty remarkable comeback for the Cougars. Not saying it can't happen, but it certainly looks like the Bombers will get a 2-win weekend, which now we're going to get another stoppage here. I didn't see what. Oh, we're going to get another penalty against the Bombers again. And so for the second time in this game, the Cougars will have a 5-on-3. And it looks like Dominic McKenzie's afternoon is done. It's going to stay 5-on-4, so maybe McKenzie just got a 10-minute misconduct. Yeah, so McKenzie gets a 10-minute misconduct at 16:42. Didn't see exactly what happened there. And there's another save by Burroughs, but not able to take care of the rebound. Hudson Clark makes it a 5-1 game. The goal coming after the penalty had expired. Hudson Clark with the goal. for Clark, his sixth goal, 11th point of the season. And I don't know if there will be any assists. Clark with the initial shot, Burrows the save. Clark picked up his own, and the first save was an incredible save. And it is an unassisted goal. There's another shot that gets deflected, goes up over the glass, out of play. So Hudson Clark, sixth goal, 15th point, or sorry, sixth goal, 11th point, unassisted at 16:54, makes it a 5-1 game. Draw played down into the corner. Steele trying to clear it past the defenseman, not able to do so. Now in behind the net, turning, changing directions, Reynolds. Puck comes to the line. Murphy sending it back down the boards. Steele gets it, plays it off the wall. It bounces over Murphy's stick. Hustling back to pick up there is McDougal. Colton McDougal plays it out to Seymour. Seymour has to back up with it. McDougal on it again here. 2:14 to go, third period. Pass broken up by McDonald, but not able to hold the puck onside, and so we'll get a stoppage with 2:07 left. So again, our next broadcast for the Bombers will be next Saturday. And I believe that's a 5 o'clock puck drop, that game on Saturday, so you can catch that right here on this same link within 360 Live. And then the Bombers do play at home on Sunday, but that game will be over on the other sheet of ice again, so it will not be available here through Petter Pictou Sports, because I will be busy broadcasting the week's majors game of the Nova Scotia Under 18 Major Hockey League here on this sheet of ice at the same time. And we haven't quite figured out how to clone me yet, so until then, I can only do one game at a time. Austin plays it around for Thompson. Thompson gets it ahead to the line and just out. Played back in, now back out again. Here comes Thompson with it as we're down to the final 95 seconds. McIsaac plays it back. Now Sim with the forces the turnover. Sim has a couple of players on him. Sim trying to get himself some space. Gets taken off of the puck. Played ahead to McDonald. Now some pushing and shoving there along the far wall. Puck comes free and players all separate, and now it's out to center. Austin, he makes a pass across. That gets intercepted by McDonald. McDonald trying to get away from Thompson. And Thompson not allowing McDonald to get a shot away into the final minute. Bombers that close to going up to 10-4 on the season. Cougars about to drop to 7-7. Here's McIsaac with the puck into the final 30 seconds. McIsaac back in across the line, takes the shot, Burrows the save. She'll hang on for possibly our final face-off of the game. Don't forget, we do have another game this afternoon here on Petter Pictou Sports as well, when we bring you the Maritime Major Female Under 18 Hockey League, the Northern Subway Selects, and the Station 6 Fire. Back half of a home-and-home set between those two teams. The Selects winning yesterday down in Bedford by a score of 2-0. Looking for the weekend sweep between the top two teams in the province. Again, that game at 3 o'clock this afternoon. Last couple seconds here as O'Neill will play the puck in to finish things off. And Georgia Burrows with a 36-save victory. The final score once again, 5-1 for the hometown Wherewell Bombers. In my mind, the star of the game, that young lady right there, Georgia Burrows, 36 saves on 37 shots. You can certainly look at Cade Mosier with a pair of goals. I thought Sinclair I thought Seymour had a good game for the Cougars. Pilling, I thought, played well. Clark, of course, had the goal for the Cougars. But the story of this game, really, once again, Georgia Burroughs, 36 saves on 37 shots to give the Werewell Bombers the 5-1 victory. Our next Bombers broadcast next Saturday, our next broadcast overall in a little less than 2 hours. Until then, this is Michael Petter saying, may your skates always be sharp, may your shots always hit the top shelf. Final score one last time, the Werewell Bombers defeat the John L. Jim Cougars 5-1. Thanks so much for watching, and enjoy the rest of your weekend.